Hello and welcome to my channel. Today I would like to bring this mainboard back to life, which has a dead real-time clock battery. Unfortunately, this model doesn't even want to start if the battery is dead. So I can't even boot to the operation system to test if this mainboard is working at all. So first of all, let's remove the battery from the mainboard. Fortunately, it is socketed, so we can just use a screwdriver to hover it out of the socket. Before we continue with our modification, let's talk about this module and what is inside first. At the time, before such a module was a standard, so-called barrel batteries been used on mainboards. Unfortunately, they leaked and damaged the mainboards badly, so this integrated module should be a solution for that problem. And they didn't leak anymore indeed. However, it was not just a battery anymore, but an integrated circuit with a battery and a real-time clock chip inside. Later, they were replaced by a standard cell battery again, but this is a different story. And today, I would like to show how you can repair such a real-time module without the need to buy a new one, which today is really rare and quite expensive too. I know that such chips were used in the late 486 mainboards and the Pentium 1 mainboards. I usually see two types of the chips. One is Odin OEC-12C887 model, and the other one is a Dallas DS-1287. They actually look the same but are a little bit different. I had mainboards where you could replace one with the other, but there are also mainboards which do work only with one of them. So if you exchange such a module, try always to take the same model which was in the mainboard before. Anyway, as I told before, there is a battery inside of this housing, and we have to find the contacts of this battery to be able to connect a new external battery to them. Well, it's not quite easy to open the housing without damaging it too much. Luckily, we don't need to do this, because you can reach the contacts of internal battery by just drilling two holes into the side of the housing. If you look to the side of the module where some pins are missing, and if you count from left to right, the contacts of the internal battery are located just above the fourth and the eighth pin of the module. Under the eighth pin, we have a plus, and under the fourth pin, we have a minus contact of the battery. If you drill a couple of millimeters somewhere around the middle of the housing, right above the pins, you will reach the internal contacts of the battery. You can use these contacts then to solder an external battery to them. I tested this modification successfully with both types of modules, Odin as well as Dallas. So far the theory. Now let's take a drill and do the actual modification. This is how the result looks like when we put it back to the mainboard. Unfortunately, I didn't make a video how it's booting, but it worked flawlessly. I added some hot glue to fix the battery in place, but this is optional. That's all from me. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you very much and goodbye.